Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My friends, around 2 weeks, after around 2 weeks, I am making my presence here. And today we will look at some of the man things, which mainly are dividing us from the remembrance of Almighty Allah. Allah says, Allazina yu'minuna bil ghaib. Those who are believing are believing in unseen. وَيَقِيمُنَ الصَّلَاةَ, and they are praying, they are offering prayers. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and they are spending from what we have given them. Allah says in Surah Al-Munafiqun, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Oh mankind, oh you who have believed, let not your wealth and your children divide you from the remembrance of Almighty Allah. First one is amwalukum. First one is property. First one is wealth. Because we are getting the love of wealth, and then after we are not able to spend on those we need, on those we are responsible. When we are getting the love of wealth, we are not able to spend on those who are needy ones. We are not able to spend on those who do not have money. When we do not spend on those who need money, definitely we are falling in the love of this dunya and we are getting away from Almighty Allah. Almighty Allah has given this charity so that the wealthy ones in the society will not remain always the wealthy ones. In Surah Hashr, Almighty Allah says, كَيْلَا يَكُونَ الْوَلَدَمْ مَنْ الْأَغْنِيَاءِ مِنْكُمْ. So that those who do have more wealth, the wealth will not remain always in their hands. But whenever we do love more to this wealth, whenever we do not give charity, whenever we do not spend for the sake of Almighty Allah, it will develop the love in our hearts, and our hearts will become harsh, and our hearts will become hard, and there will no any feeling for anyone's pain. There will be no any feeling for humanity. Second point, Vijay Abdala says, "Anwalukum wala awladukum," and let not your children divide you from the remembrance of Almighty Allah. Yeah, definitely. Because if we look at these children is also becoming one of the severe, one of the harsh thing in our life to tackle. These children can become one of the good fruit for us as well if we rightly guide him. But the same children can become one of the things which may lead us to hellfire. Because whenever we do love to these children in a proper way, then after we can guide him properly, and in that way, it will become one of the fruit for us. Tomorrow, whenever we die, it can become one of the sadaqa jariya, it can become one of the charity. But if we do not love these children in a proper way, it can become one of the things which can lead us to hellfire. If we do not love properly, the love of the children will lead us to hellfire. It will lead us to acquire more money. And whenever we get the concept of the deep love of with these children, it will not make us to distinguish from the right and the wrong. It will just make us to acquire money, to amass money, to get money, to gain money. And in that way, we do not spend. In that way, we do not remember Allah. And in that way, we will fall in hell. That is why these two things are mainly. These two are main points which are mostly deviating us from the remembrance of Almighty Allah. That's why Almighty Allah says, at many places in the Quran, لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ, let not your wealth and your children deviate you from the remembrance of Almighty Allah. Because these are the main points which are making us to fall in love in this dunya. Sadaqallahu al-Azim.